happy that we are here for Swami Anubhavananda ji's lecture series on yoga of self control, fourth part. Now I am supposed to introduce you Swami ji, which is not required, but I will introduce in different way. Swami, who is the Lord of Self? Swami. So really, Swamiji is always Swami because he always exudes the ananda. Mauj mein raho means ananda, anubhava. He gives experience. To meet him, to talk to him, to learn from him is anubhava. And he is also in continuous ananda anubhava. Now, there is no occasion, every occasion he utilizes to make us happy. We were coming and we met. I came unexpectedly here. And then we met him. He is coming. I told I will meet him. The planned thing is humanity. If it is planned thing has come, it is humanity. But unexpected thing is divinity. So, aaj divine meeting hua. And then Mr. Vyas told, you introduce him. One more unexpected. And then I told Swamiji that I will introduce you. I will give you a... Let us welcome him to Swamiji. I told I will welcome you, give you a bouquet, and tell a story and make them happy. Then he said, then I will make them miserable. That is Swamiji. Now what a guru and shishya relationship is there. What shishya should do to guru? Do everything. Give his life. Apna jaan dena chahiye. So what guru should do to shishya? Give everything. Apna jaan dena chahiye. So not only shishya, the sambandham is such that ek dusre ke liye jaan dena chahiye. Ek guruji tha, Amrit Baba, in Srinagar. And daily, Anand, Mr. Anand, who is working as a government officer, he is his dear shishya. So every Sunday, he has to take care of him. Sunday morning aata hai, vegetables leke aata hai, khana banata hai, lunch deke chala hai. Sunday mornings is the responsibility of Anand. So ek din Sunday aaya, then Babaji was waiting, Amrit Baba, Anand, aaye ho? Then he said, pranam kiya, pura, namaste kiya, aur bola, sir, mai vegetable leke aunga. He went to market and he is supposed to come back after 45 minutes or something. He came back within 10 minutes. And thaili khali tha, thaili phek diya. Bola, Swamiji, mai ja raha hu. Kahan ja rahe? Jammu. Why you are Jammu? Mai ek minute yahan Srinagar mein nahi rahunga. Abhi mai jaunga. Mera khana ka kya hoga? Kuch bhi hone deo, aapka khana. Bol ke he did Punjabi namaskar. Punjabi namaskar is the easiest namaskar. You did not reach and do pranam, kuch karne ka jarurat nahi. Aisa, dusre. Sometimes secret, aisa karne ka. And nowadays all my shishas are doing Punjabi namaskar to me. Why they are doing Punjabi namaskar? If they come near and do pranam, I will embrace them. And the moment I embrace, I will come to know, Ratku piya ki nahi piya? Snan kiya ki nahi kiya? So, isliye ye jhanjat kya? Punjabi namaskar karo. So, like Anand also did aisa and started going. He said, what is the matter? Why you are running away to Jammu? He said, nahi Swamiji, I went to market and waha mujhe Yamraj dikha. With big mustaches, buffalo, gada and all that. They came, main dar gaya. He is looking at me like a third thing. So he is going to kill me. So my Srinagar mein rahega to marega, isliye main bhag raha hu. Bola, aise bhagne se kuch nahi hoga, don't go. Then he went away. Then Swamiji ne pray kiya. He summoned Yamraj. So Yamraj appeared with black and white lights shining like this, dark and white strips. Yamraj dekha. Swamiji, Guruji, aap yaad kiya mujhe? Haan, yaad kiya. Ye Anand ka piche kyon padhaya tum? Usko kya? Kya Anand ko kya hua? Tum market mein dekh ke usko dharaya. Anand, what is he doing in Srinagar? आई हैव टू कलेक्ट इन जम्मू विद इन 45 मिनट्स. सो बोला उधर ही गया वो. बोला करेक्ट डायरेक्शन में गया. देन बाबा बोला आनंद यंग है, लेट हिम लिव एंड ए वेरी गुड कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटर, डिवोटी, सिंसियर, लेट हिम लिव फॉर 5 मोर इयर्स. नहीं नहीं, यू नो दैट इट इज ऑलरेडी रिटर्न. बाबा जी ये नहीं हो सकता है, ब्रह्मा जी ने लिखा है ऑलरेडी. मिस्टर भाई सत्यवान को नहीं हुआ, नचकेत को नहीं हुआ, मार्कंडेय को नहीं हुआ, ध्रुव को नहीं हुआ, इसको क्यों नहीं होता है? बोला सर दे आर स्पेशल यू नो. देन इमीडिएटली स्वामी जी फेस बिकेम ब्राइट, आईज ओपन, ह्यूमिडिटी से आनंद इज ऑर्डिनरी. वो डर गया क्योंकि उसका मैं ब्रह्म तेज देखा, यमराज सा ब्रह्म तेज इन स्वामी जी. ही सेड ऐसा नहीं हो सकता है. देन ही गॉट एन आइडिया, ही स्माइल्ड विथ ए ग्लिंट इन द आई. ही सेड स्वामी जी ठीक है, आपका जैसा गुरु है तो हो सकता है, अगर आपका 10 साल निकाल देगा तो उसको 5 साल मिलेगा. बोला अभी क्या बोलेगा बाबा. बाबा इमीडिएटली सेड यस, टेक माई 10 ईयर्स एंड लेट हिम लिव 5 ईयर्स. यमराज सेड यस सर बोल के डिम हो गया. ठहरो बोला, फिर अगेन ब्राइट हो गया. व्हाट इज माई टोटल लाइफ? वो बोला बोल नहीं सकता है, लेकिन आप तो ब्रह्म समान दिखता है. 18 बरस में 10 गया 5 साल के लिए. यस, टेक एंटायर 18 ईयर्स एंड लेट हिम लिव फॉर 9 ईयर्स. यमराज सरप्राइज्ड, ही सेड डन. देन ही डिम्ड अगेन, ही केम ब्राइट. स्वामी जी आप तो ब्रह्म समान है, आप तो पूरा त्याग ही नहीं किए अमृतत्व मानसु, आप तो पूरा लाइफ त्याग किया अपना शिष्य के लिए, इसलिए आप भी 18 बरस जियेंगे और आनंद भी 18 बरस जियेंगे. स्वामी जी वॉज हैप्पी, यमराज वेंट. स्टोरी खत्म नहीं हुआ, स्टोरी कभी खत्म नहीं होता है. वन डे यमराज रिसीव्ड अ टेलीफोन कॉल फ्रॉम ब्रह्मा जी. बोला अर्जेंटली कम, ब्रह्मा जी कॉलिंग यू. बोल के उसका सेक्रेटरी बुलाया. सो यमराज केम रनिंग, देयर वाज अ पेपर रिपोर्ट इन फ्रंट ऑफ. ही सेड यमराज यू हैव एक्सीडेड योर लिमिट्स. क्या हुआ? इन दिस केस ऑफ आनंद योर मैक्सिमम लिमिट इज 5 ईयर्स. बोले तो मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर को 10 लाख रहता है ना ऐसा. सो योर लिमिट इज 5 ईयर्स, हाउ यू हैव गिवन हिम 18 ईयर्स. एंड ही एंड गुरु ऑल्सो. ही सेड सर when that Baba was telling, in his face I saw your light. So when he said let him live, I thought it is your order. इसलिए मैं ऐसा किया. लेकिन आपको अगर पसंद नहीं है तो मेरा 18 बरस आप कमती करिए. ब्रह्मा स्माइल्ड. सो गुरु शुड बी एबल टू डू एवरीथिंग लाइक बाबा डिड. एंड अवर स्वामी अनुभवानंद जी इज like Babaji, but neither he is going to die, not he is going to allow you to die. Thank you very much.
Shri Krishna, Shri Krishna, Shri Krishna, Shri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma. तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः, तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः. वन नाइट एट अबाउट 2 o'clock अ चाइल्ड वेक्स अप फ्रॉम द स्लीप एंड स्टार्ट्स क्राई. मम्मी मम्मी आई टू गो टू बाथरूम. देन गो, व्हाट इज देयर टू क्राई? इट इज नॉट ए क्राइम. गो, इफ यू डू इट इन द बेड देन इट इज अ क्राइम. गो. नो आई एम अफ्रेड, आई कांट गो, it is darkness there. Mummy wakes up, takes the child, and he finishes purnamadah purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate. Spiritual, you know. And he comes back. Now for the child, going from the room, bedroom, to the bathroom was a destination to be covered by crossing a distance. Bedroom is somewhere, bathroom is somewhere. For the mother, the path and the destination were the same. The house was the path, the house was the destination. See, friends, in the same manner, path to reality means you are the destination and you are the path. How simple it is? We don't have to go anywhere. See, it is not a journey to be crossed in time, space, covering distances, achieving something or losing something. No. It is a journey without a journey. It is a gain without a gain. It is a gain without a pain. And to understand this, we require qualification. See, friends, there is no, unfortunately, I'll put it fortunately. Fortunately, there is no reservation on this path. You have to be qualified. Many grihasthas have this complaint. Swami, it is okay for you, you are a Swami, but you know, we are grihasthas and how can we do it? It is very difficult. So what do you want to say? Grihasthas should have 95% reservation and sannyasi should struggle throughout life. See? If it is difficult, then put more efforts. That is important. And what kind of efforts we will put depends on what kind of personality we have. See, if our personality is only money-oriented, one old Mahatma in Delhi, he told me many years before, that time I was young, handsome, etc., etc. You are the only one who could recognize. Okay. So, he told me, Dekho beta, I'll tell you some secret. These are the professional secrets. Yes. You should talk according to the type of audiences in front of you. I said, yes, sir. What I should do? He said, there are 2-3 types of audiences which are to be addressed. If you are addressing the Punjabi crowd, then you should talk Vedanta. Punjabis are very well receiving Vedanta. Good. If you are talking to Gujaratis, then you should talk Jai Shri Krishna. Only devotion. Without devotion, but you should talk devotion. See? And when it comes to Marwadis, don't talk Vedanta, don't talk devotion. Talk only how to purify the money. Dhana Shuddhi. See? If you give 10% of your earnings for such and such cause, your other Sham will become Ram. So depending upon what we consider ourselves to be, is our spiritual practice. See, when we are all the time body-oriented, living by the body, living for the body, living on everybody, such type of person, for him, spirituality means what? Yoga. And yoga means what? Twisting the body and never straightening the mind. That is the yoga. Throughout the world, this is how the tragedy of yoga is. I was in Stuttgart, in Germany. My hostile, I don't know the feminine gender of host. So the husband is the host, the wife is hostile, and children are hostilities. But fortunately, they had no children because they were not husband and wife. They were only, he is my boyfriend and she is my girlfriend. And both of them, 60, not out, and how boyfriend and girlfriend got. Anyway, they were like that. And when I was there, one day, second day only, she was sitting like this. Ab ji ke kya karenge? So I asked her, Amma, what's wrong with you? Something bothering you? No, I'm worried about one thing. Only one thing? Congratulations. There are many things to worry. you are really funneled, narrowed down your point of worry. It must be very intense worry, is it not? See, I was the first to introduce yoga in Germany. First one. And after that I started yoga studio. 20 students were trained. How many years course? No, it was a 6 weeks crash course. Yoga crashed. And in the 6 weeks, it was 3 days a week and per day half an hour. 6 weeks yoga course. After I completed the course, I gave them certificate. Then 20 of them have opened 20 different studios, yoga studios. And you know, in this manner, it started ramification. And today the condition is, in Germany, we have got more of teachers and no students. I said, import from India. India got plenty of them. See? So yoga, for those who are body oriented, for them yoga means only twisting the body. And their achievement is, I can sit in one posture without movement for 10 minutes. What is great about it? Even our buffalo sit for hours together. Nothing great about it. In the same manner, when we want to understand the path of self-control, what is the meaning of self-control for us? This is the theme we are going to discuss today. Many people have got this funny notion. Swamiji, since I met you, I came on this line. And thereafter, now I have stopped completely non-vegetarian. Then what do you eat? I graze now. Strictly vegetarian. Earlier, I used to drink every day. Now, alternate days. Improvement, you know. In this manner, our definition of walking the spiritual path depends on what we have been thinking about ourselves. See? See, friends? Now I get up very early in the morning, 9:45. Earlier it was 10 o'clock. 15 minutes improvement. See? Therefore, when we talk about the path of reality, we have to clearly understand basic principle. See? In absolute consciousness, there is no problem. See? In absolute matter, there is no problem. See? It is something like, in only electricity, there is no light. In only bulb, there is no light. See? And when there is a light, the world begins. See? In the same manner, in absolute consciousness, there is no world, no life. In absolute matter, there is no world, no life. But when the consciousness expresses through the matter as mind, from then onwards, the world begins. So the total problem, the world, is existing only in the mind. See? When we enfold our mind and take it below our head as a pillow in deep sleep, that time, where are we? What are we? See, we are nobody. And because we are nobody, we are happy. See, otherwise husband and wife sleeping together happily, is it possible? And yet they are happy only because both of them are nobody. Husband is not husband, therefore he can smile. One lady and her husband, they went to the doctor. And lady told the doctor, "Doctor, my husband talks the whole night. I get fed up. I don't know what I should do. Please do something." So the doctor takes out some medicine and he tells, "Amma, you take this." "Doctor, you are having some wrong understanding. I told my husband is having a problem. Whole night he talks. And you are giving me, I understand your problem. Please, you take this medicine." Then what will happen? Then he will be able to talk during day. Then he doesn't have to talk at night. Because you don't allow him to talk the whole day. Therefore, he takes the revenge at night. See? Wherever there is a mind, the world begins. And therefore, path to reality, the first topic is the cultivating the mind. See, friends, first topic, most important. We all know that in the jungle, forest, and in the garden, both the places, there are only trees and trees and trees. But when we have to go to jungle, or we happen to go to jungle or forest, we are afraid. Because the vegetation is uncontrolled growth. There are wild animals. There is fear. There is loneliness. And we want to get away. On the contrary, if we go to the garden, see, everything is so beautiful. No fear. See, that is why the people come there in the garden, because there is no fear, they fall in love in the garden. See, and those who go to the forest, they don't fall in love. They are, you know, rising in love to the divine. See the difference. Mahatmas go to the forest and Chota Atmas go to the gardens. See, CH Atma, they go to the garden. See. So when we go to the garden, it is so cheerful and happy, no fear. And when we go to the forest, it is so terrible. Now see these two examples within. We are all afraid of ourselves. See? Those who are workaholics, there used to be one lady in Bombay. She used to come and always help me clean my room and things. One day I told her, I said, Mama, what is the magic in your hand? You come in 5 minutes, my room becomes so perfectly well. I don't know, what do you do? She says, Swamiji, I have also got one question. What is that? What is the magic in your hand? In 2 seconds you make everything mess again. Everything gets mixed up. So she asked me one day, Swamiji, I never ask you, you know my life fully, kindly tell me some piece of advice and observation on me, whether I am walking the spiritual path or not. I said, shall I tell you the truth or bluff? I have both options. She said, for a change, tell the truth. I said, all right. Then I told her, I said, you are afraid of yourself. Therefore, you are constantly running away from yourself. See, friends, expose yourself to your own mind without running away anywhere. See? And then we come to discover what a terrible jungle our mind is. There is uncontrolled eruptions of thoughts. See, the other day we are going to one place, very beautiful place in the mountains, and on the way there were many poultry farms. So one girl was sitting next to me. Swamiji, you always tell us when you see the things, you get an example. Now tell me. See, these are the poultry farm. What is the example? I said, example is, look within. Inside you, there is a poultry farm. See? We talk maximum to ourselves. Stop talking to yourself. See? And we cannot stop. So what do we do? Guptaji, kya kar rahe ho? No, I am busy. Nahi, main bore ho raha tha, isliye aaya. Why you were bored? Was there somebody? No, I was alone. Oh, you are bored of yourself? What a solid bore you must be. When we are bored of ourselves, you know. It is something like, you know, one patient went to the doctor and told, Doctor Saab, when I sleep, I snore so loudly that I wake up because of my own snoring. What should I do? See, the doctors also have got big problems. Doctor said, go and sleep in the other room. See, friends, we all have this one common problem. That is, mind is a monster. See? And how the mind works? Like nobody wants to die unless you are from Australia. You know, when people come from Australia, for the first time when I heard, I said, hey, when did you come to die? I said, I am not asking you the purpose. I ask you, when did you come? He said, to die. I said, no, no purpose, you die anyway. See? So, when we are observing our mind, then we are working on the path to reality. Observe the mind. And to observe the mind, what is required is, we have to be little steady and clear about it. Now, this time onwards, I am going to observe the mind. The following observations will come. Number one, mind survives on its own diet. Like, you know, our gross body survives by taking the gross food. Similarly, the mind has its own diet. And what is that diet? That diet is, the past memories are scratched again and again. The second diet is, we are struggling to solve the non-existing problems called as worries. See? One day I was going to Badrinath, and one lady, NRI, she was with me. And when we saw the, she saw the big, you know, valley kind of thing, and our bus going, and she says, Swamiji, suppose our bus falls? I didn't reply. Swamiji, you are not replying. Suppose our bus falls. He said, there is no need to reply. That will be the reply. See? Therefore, the mind, either it is digging the grave of the past memories, or it is struggling to solve the non-existing problems. How does it does? It will create a problem. Suppose I don't get admission. Now start. Why suppose? Go on imagination. So the mind is either carrying the load of the past, or worrying about the future, or in the present, it is constantly comparing with A, with B, B with C, and in this manner, these are the three diets: carbohydrates, fats, and proteins. Past is the carbohydrate, bulk, depending upon the age. And then the future is the fat. See? And the present one is the protein. Non-stop comparison. And in this way the mind survives. Now, if we want really to reach the goal that we are, what is the instrument that is used? The instrument is mind. But the mind is not under our control. So to control the mind is to cultivate the mind. See? To control a jungle is to cultivate a garden. In the jungle also, as in the garden there are trees, in the same manner, a mind lost in the world is also entertaining thoughts. And a mind self-oriented is also entertaining thoughts. So there are two types of thoughts. Technically they are called as vikar and vichar. Kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya. Desire, anger, greed, lust, passion, envy, jealousy, frustration, depression. See? These are all the vikar, the unhealthy modifications of the mind. When these are predominantly the contents of our mind is like a jungle. Yahoo! It's a big jungle. And therefore we are fed up of ourselves. See? Contrary to that, if the thoughts are according to the wisdom given by our Upanishads or Gita, then we are no more asking, be very attentive, why and how. Why and how, these are the true words which create problems. See? One day, one father told his son, why don't you study and get first? Dad, it is impossible. I cannot. So the dad said, do you know, Napoleon's dictionary did not have the word impossible. So the son said, maybe old dictionary. So, why and how? These are the two words which create a jungle in our mind. See? If you really want to cultivate mind, drop these two words for good. You will ask a question, but why? And how? So our total life is whiling away by howling at life. And wherever we have not asked the question why, there we have acted properly. See? See how simple it is. Like, you know, in India, in Vishesh, in our Ahmedabad. We know Ahmedabad traffic is unique. Now those people who are from Ahmedabad, they never complain. They know why the people are like that. No. But when a person from outside comes, he gets frustrated. Why the people are doing like this thing? Even they want to show the direction, the rickshawala takes out the leg. Why? Why? Because the sky is too high. See, never get into this kind of thinking. Be very attentive. I have a friend in the US and I stay with him. He has two children, one son, one daughter. Son is doing very well. He is in Stanford and doing very well. Extremely bright student. And his younger sister, she was learning this Bharatanatyam. You know Bharatanatyam? Simple things made complicated is Bharatanatyam. I never understand what inspired these girls to Bharatanatyam. Instead of doing simple namaskar, namaste, aha, guma phira karke, you don't know what is going to happen. And namaste, useless. But they do that. And instead of walking normally, they will go on hitting. Are walk properly. What is this, hitting the floor? And she was hitting the floor to such an extent that her, you know, heels got hurt. And thereafter it became so bad that hardly a girl in class 6 or 7, she has to go to the school on a wheelchair. You can imagine. It was so bad. So when this happened, then her grandmother and uncle and they started discussing, but why should this happen to our sweet little girl? We have not done anything bad to anybody. Why God is punishing her? And her father, he was listening, doing what is to be done. He was never commenting. Finally, they said, you don't have to say anything. Then he said, okay, you want me to say? You have been listening to Swamiji all through life, is it not? Yes. What did he say? Don't use these two words in your life. Why and how? Why this has happened? How this has happened? Is not the problem. The problem is, now you dissolve the problem. Don't go into the history of the problem. See? Suppose your house is on fire. Will you take the phone and dial the fire brigade? Hanji, kaise ho, theek hai, bahut dino se try kar raha tha, mauka hi nahi aa raha. God bless me that I can contact you. Everything is okay. Now fire brigade fellow can never receive such a phone. He said, I think wrong number. No, not wrong number. This is fire brigade. Yes. व्हाई डिड यू रिंग? नहीं कुछ नहीं, अपना घर जरा जल रहा है. Will you say like this thing? When your house is on fire, you don't go into cause and effect. You want to dissolve the problem there and then. In the same manner. Don't get lost into unwanted inquiry. See friends, this unwanted inquiry is a technique used by the mind not to allow us to stay in the present. See friends, why this has happened? Pata nahi pichle jaram mein paap kiya hoga. Don't get into that wrong mode of thinking. See? And we all do this. About the fire, this example I gave a number of times. When the fire burns our finger for the first time in our life, we know that it burns the finger. It is hot. Did we ever inquire why the fire is hot? We only accept the fire is hot. And thereafter, deal with the fire in such a manner that the burning ability of the fire is to our benefit. That is what is called as living intelligently and making a garden of our mind, which is presently a jungle. See, friends. Therefore, never get lost in these kind. This is what is called as cultivating the mind. Don't ask unnecessary questions. Therefore, whenever anybody comes and talks to me on anything, these are the two conditions I put very clearly. No discussions, no arguments. See? If these two things you remove, there is nothing. You have to simply listen. See? But Swamiji, there is no butting. See? Straight away. And this ultimately leads to that we start remaining in the present. Be very, very attentive. When we ask the question, why, we are not in the present. Because the cause is always prior to the effect. Prior to the effect means in the past. Effect is in the present. So whenever we ask a question, but why this has happened? Then we are told, maybe when I was a child, I have killed one mosquito and then that mosquito has taken another birth and has come in the form of a cobra. You know the meaning of cobra? Kokunastha Brahman. See? Don't get into all that nonsense. You will destroy yourself. See? Remain in the utter present. Why? Don't worry. It happened, now solve it. Second thing, when we get lost in how, we are again not in the present, we are going in the future. So these are the two gateways. You know, there are three gateways to hell. You all know that, is it not? Everybody says yes. Experience. त्रिविधं नरकसेदं द्वारं नाशनमात्मनः कामक्रोधस्तथा लोभः तस्माद् एतत् त्रयं त्यजेत्. देर आर थ्री गेटवेज टू हेल, द डिजायर, एंगर एंड द ग्रीड. देयरफॉर गिव अप ऑल द थ्री. सिमिलरली द गेटवेज टू द पास्ट इज व्हाय, द गेटवेज टू द फ्यूचर इज हाउ. सी, व्हेन यू स्टॉप दीज टू थिंग्स. How to do this? There was one person. He had this about everything. Swamiji, I understand. But how to control the mind? I said, why you worry about my mind? No, not your mind. My own mind. I said, then you mind your mind. Why should I worry about your mind? But how? I said, let you decide. Your question is like what? We should not jump into the water if we do not know how to swim. Yes. We cannot learn swimming unless we jump into the water. Yes. So how do we start? Write notes on swimming. Submit a thesis. Get a PhD and get drowned. See, friends. This is not the way to lead life. Therefore, we arrest the migration of the mind in the illusion of the past and the fantasy of the future, and keep the mind in the present. See, friends, and when the mind remains in present, that time, be very attentive, you are Mr. Nobody. Take an example. When you laugh after understanding a joke, there are people who laugh without understanding a joke also. They are called as tube lights. When everybody laughs, like that. Isn't it? In the today's world, the mothers are digital, the children are digital, everything is digitalized. So one mother got very angry with the child, and the software mother, how she will scold her son. I have given you birth, my dear. I did not download you, okay? Now, if you understood and heard and laughed, that moment of laughter, you were in the utter present. But if you were somebody, everybody is laughing. I'm not cheap. I never laugh. I'm a Dumbo. One day I remember this experience. One lady was sitting right in front in one corner seat. It was a school function, annual day. And about 2,000 children, so 3,000 parents or 4,000 parents, and a huge crowd in Thane it happened. And the whole, you know, crowd was laughing, giggling, ha-ha. There was one lady sitting in the front as if she has taken a vratam. I am not going to laugh. Finally, when I finished my talk, I went down to her. I said, Mama, I accept I am defeated. You did not laugh even once. She took her hanky in front of her mouth and she said, Swamiji, it is not. I was laughing. But I am coming directly from the dentist. It was a new denture. I was holding it. I don't know. Had I laughed, it would have come and beaten you on the stage. See, friends, when we remain in the utter present, we are at our best. See, friends, when we are at our best, we are